The Xavier-Kansas State game two nights ago was the best game of the NCAA tournament, at least so far. The Wildcats prevailed in two overtimes, but after 50 minutes in the altitude of Salt Lake City, how much would K-State have left in the tank today for the Elite Eight? The Wildcats and the Butler Bulldogs playing for that first spot in the Final Four, and early on, here's Curtis Kelly, the big fellow with the spin move and the lefty. But K-State down by 7 at halftime, and Butler came to play today. Willie Beasley to Matt Howard. He goes in for the reverse, and the Bulldogs lead by 10. Wildcats come storming back. Jacob Pullen spotting up for 3, and the lead is 7. Here's Pullen again, and the Cats trail by just 4. Then Dennis Clemente misses the free throw, but he will get it back, and then he pulls up for yet another 3, and K-State takes the lead by a point. But then the Wildcats fall asleep. Gordon Hayward gets the lob for the layup, and Butler goes back up by 2. And then Hayward puts it on the floor and puts it home. K-State falters down the stretch, and Butler wins 63-56. The Bulldogs advance to their first Final Four ever, and the winningest season in Kansas State history comes to an end.
Real proud of our guys, giving me an unbelievable ride this year, giving K-Staters an unbelievable ride this year. With all that said, this moment right now is not about K-State, it's about Butler University. And they absolutely kicked our tails and very well deserving of going to Indianapolis and representing their school and their conference at the Final Four.
West Virginia and the obviously nervous Kentucky Wildcats in the East Final. With 4 seconds left, here comes Turbo John Wall. He misses the layup, but he does connect with the West Virginia cheerleaders. How you doing, ma'am? UK trails by 2 at halftime. In the second half, here comes Joe Mazzulla, and the Mountaineers lead by 11. And John Wall is trying to bring Kentucky back. 19 points for the fabulous freshman, and it's a 7-point game. But you don't want to forget about Joe Mazzulla. Where's Joe Mazzulla? It's Mazzulla Oblongata, a career-high 17 for Mazzulla. And how about this? For the first time since the days of Jerry West, West Virginia is going to the Final Four. The Mountaineers beat Kentucky 73-66. So with Kansas State's loss, the Baylor Bears are the only Big 12 team still alive in the Big Dance. With each win, the Bears extend their best season since the 1940s, and after destroying St. Mary's yesterday, Baylor is just one win away from the Final Four.
Gaining confidence, we've been having that all through the season. It started in the summer, and it just carried over towards the season. But we got to come out and, the same intensity that we had last night, but better.
So tomorrow night, it's the KXII Sports Grudge Match. David Reed's Baylor Bears against my beloved Blue Devils. David and I were going to bet $1,000 on this game, but then we remembered we don't have any money. And of course, as professional sports journalists, we will both remain neutral and impartial. Tennessee and Michigan State play in the first game at 1:20. All your highlights tomorrow night on Sports Overtime. The Baylor women are also in the Sweet 16, taking on top seed Tennessee. And apparently we don't have video of Baylor and top seed Tennessee. Why don't we move on to the Dallas Mavericks, perhaps? Taking on the Golden State Warriors? We don't have them either, so why don't we go to break and maybe we'll have them after we get back.
Flashy
Jack. Hey, we're back, and so is our video. The Baylor women in the Sweet 16 taking on top seed Tennessee. Melissa Jones hits Taryn Condry, and Baylor ends the half on a big run, leads by 2 at the break. In the second half, Jones hits another 3 to give Baylor the lead by 2, and then they go inside to Brittany Griner. She had 26 points and 10 blocks. Lady Bears win 77-62. The Baylor women will also take on Duke in the women's Elite Eight. I guess irony can be pretty ironic sometimes. Dallas Mavericks forward Caron Butler was fined $25,000 by the NBA for directing inappropriate language toward the fans during the Mavs game against Portland on Thursday. When told about the fine, Butler said, "Oh, hamburgers." Mavericks in Golden State tonight, and there's Caron Butler. He's going to spot it for 3, and as it goes in, you can hear him say, "Jumpin' Jehoshaphat Joe Friday." Later on in the first, they're going to get it to Dirk Nowitzki, and he will hit the fadeaway jumper right there. Not pictured in these highlights, Rodrigue Beaubois had 26 points in the first half, and the Mavs lead 67-41 at the break. so they are on their way to another win. In Texoma today, the Grayson County Vikings sweep a doubleheader from Weatherford. East Central takes two from Northeastern up in Ada, and Austin College gets two walk-off wins against Millsaps College here in Sherman. In softball today, Austin College splits with Hendricks. East Central upsets number two Angelo State, and in high school, the Tom Bean Lady Cats beat Honey Grove 11-7, and we will be right back.